Fly through the air as I head to fulfill my purpose. To shake the whole earth with a boom when I hit the surface. They trembling nervous. They know I'm coming for certain. Tomorrow, all these niggas devour all of these serpents. I patiently waited to turn up with fervent heat now that I'm activated. I'ma blow cause it's World War III. I hear you weeping. You're mourning. Your nationality. Hiroshima and Nagasaki ain't got nothing on me. I was raised by chemists. I was made for the judgment. Don't be testing my limits. Don't be pushing my buttons. In the Bible, they call me flame and rebuke. And you know that that's the truth, but my homies call me Nuke. I was sent here to destroy pleasures and sin. In the day of darkness, even darker than when the day began. Annihilation, no time for evacuations. When these warheads split, it look worse than decapitations. Repentidize it, just genocide or it's genocide.
I'd be damn if I'm gonna leave this sheep out here, Gavin. I'ma hold the line.
Look, I'm going to show you.
We are the promised.
Yeah, we the promise. We the children of the promise. We broke God's commandments and we went into slavery. You know what I'm saying? The Most High reduced us to nothing. What you say, bro?
Listen, what I want to say to you is 20, 30 years ago, they didn't have education like they give it, like you giving these people now.
Oh, yeah.
Nobody tell them that.
Well, check this out. The truth was out 20, 30 years ago, but like you said, it wasn't widespread and what it is now. Listen to this. I'm going to show you why we're in the conditions we're in, why God has plagued his people. Read Leviticus chapter 26, start at verse 14.
The book of Leviticus chapter 26 and verse 14.
Listen to this. Read.
But if you will not hearken unto me.
God told the Israelites, if you don't want to hearken to me, who are the Israelites, you so-called blacks and Hispanics? You so-called Native American Indians? You are the Israelites. Read.
And will not do all these commandments.
He said, brother, we don't want to do his commandments. God gave us instructions. God said, if you don't want to follow my instructions, read.
And if you shall despise my statutes.
He said, if you despise these instructions that I give to you, read on.
Or if your soul abhor my judgment.
Read on.
So that you will not do all my commandments.
Read.
But that you break my covenant.
He said, if you break my covenant, verse 17.
And I will set my face against you.
He said, I'm going to set my face against you. God told the Israelites, if you break my covenant, I'm going to set my face against you. I'm going to be against you. Our people be calling upon God, wondering why God ain't answering, because God is against our people right now. God is against our people. Read that again. Listen.
And I will set my face against you.
God said, if you break my covenant, we the ones who made a covenant with God. God said, you keep my commandments, I'm going to bless you. And I'm going to set you above all nations on earth. But if you break my commandments, I'm going to destroy you. And I'm going to send you to slavery. And your enemies going to rule over you. Read.
And ye shall be slain before your enemies.
God said, you break my commandments, you're going to be slain before your enemies. You're going to be killed. You're going to be shot down before your enemies in the streets. Hey, y'all brothers, come on over here and hear the word of God. Learn your true nationality. Learn what we need to do to get out of this captivity. Yeah, you can ask me something. What you want to ask?
I want to ask you, they're so-called, if everybody not understanding what you're saying or how you're saying, can you make it easier for them to understand?
Well, I'm going to tell you this. Go to Psalm 111, verse 10.
Yeah, yeah.
All I can do is come out here and prophesy. In order to get to understand that this is what you got to do. As you hear this word, it's
everybody
up to you.
Might not
listen to them. I better tell you what you got to do. Listen, everybody understand thou shalt not kill.
I understand.
Everybody understand thou shalt not steal. Listen to me. Everybody understand thou shalt not commit adultery. But you understand these things. Listen, read.
The book of Psalms, chapter 111, verse 10.
Listen, read.
The fear of the Lord is the beginning of wisdom.
Read.
A good understanding have all they that do his commandments.
So the good understanding comes when they start to do the commandments. Listen to me. Like the commandments say, don't steal. That's easy to do, right? Is it not easy for you to go up in Walgreens and not steal nothing? That's easy. You don't have to go in Walgreens and steal nothing. That's easy. Thou shalt not commit adultery. Sleep with another man's wife. That's easy for me not to sleep with another man's wife. Hell, just go get your own woman. So look, this is what I'm saying. This is what I'm trying to tell you. It's a good understanding to have all they that do the commandments. And for the people who can't catch on right now, get 2 Timothy 2 and 15. Everybody ain't gonna get it off top. We ain't expecting that. But they should understand, okay, God said, look,
they're basics,
that's it. And the basics is God's laws. And God's laws is easy to understand. No buying and selling and working on the Lord's Sabbath, Friday sundown or Saturday sundown. That's the Sabbath sun, that's the Lord's Sabbath day. No buying, selling, and working, no cooking. That's easy to understand right there. Read what you got.
The book of 2 Timothy, chapter 2 and verse 15.
Read.
Study to show thyself approved unto God.
You hear that? Our people got to study. God said our people destroyed for a lack of knowledge. So if this word come out, you got to sit up there and say, look, let me listen to these scriptures. Let me write down the scriptures. You got pen and paper in your pocket? In your backpack?
Yes,
take your pen and paper out and write down the scriptures so you can study it.
If my kid's hungry today,
yes, sir.
And it's Saturday, and on a no Sabbath day, and my kid's hungry, and I ask the Lord, but if they hungry right now, how far should I go?
All right, get Exodus 16, verse 23. He gave us a commandment about that, too. The Lord know Negroes. He know Negroes. The Lord know us. He know. That's how we think. Well, Lord, if we can't cook on Saturday, what should I do? I'm going to show you what he said do. Exodus 16 and 23.
The book of Exodus, chapter 16 and verse 23.
Listen to this.
He said unto them, this is that which the Lord hath said. Tomorrow is the rest of the holy Sabbath.
He said, look, tomorrow is the rest of the holy Sabbath. Friday, sundown, and Saturday, sundown, is the Lord's holy Sabbath day. Read.
Unto the Lord.
Read.
Bake that which you will bake today.
He said, look, cook what you're going to cook today. He said, you cook it the day before the Sabbath. Read on. Listen.
And see that ye will see, and that which remaineth over, lay up for you to keep until the morning.
He said, look, bake what you're going to bake today and save some for tomorrow. That's what we do. Everybody, listen to me. Don't cook. You cook it Friday before the sun go down. And then tomorrow, with the next day when you get up, then you eat it.
Now I'm understanding what you said.
That's what I'm saying right there.
We gonna be hungry today, but you gonna
you ain't gonna be hungry at all, because this is what you gonna do.
He gonna bless us tomorrow.
Yeah, the food. Cook your food one day early, and he's showing you that that
we
is a blessing to have that food for the next day. That's
without
listen.
A struggle, you can have no future.
Listen to me. This is what he's saying. Cook that food the day before, and you're going to see this blessing that's laid up to the morning for you. That's what he's saying. It's going to remain to the morning. The Lord basically said, look, I'm giving you enough food. He said, I'm giving you enough food for 2 days. That's what he's saying to us. So the Lord got everything up in his Bible. Go back to Baruch real quick. Leviticus chapter 26. And see, we went into slavery because we didn't want to keep the Lord's Sabbath day. We want to cook food on the Sabbath. Hell, you can read about a man picking up sticks to build a fire to cook food on the Sabbath. You know what I'm saying? The Lord put him to death. So we always got that mindset in us to want to do our own will instead of do the will of God. That's why our people in a destroyed state right now. Look at our communities. I ain't even gonna call this a community. Look at the areas that we stay in.
Right.
We populate the poor parts of the city. For real, read. You can tell our people being played. Read.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 26 and verse 17.
Read.
And I will set my face against you.
So God told the Israelites, if you break my commandments, I'm going to set my face against you. I'm going to be against you, Negroes. God against Negroes. It is what it is.
Right.
You can go to church all you want, and they can say, look, church, get your money. That's it.
Right.
Church will tell you, you know why you ain't getting a blessing? Because you withholding from God. God said, you ain't going to be blessed till you start to keep my commandments.
That's
God
right.
said, I'm going to curse you. He said, I'm going to do what? Read.
And I will set my face against you.
God said, I'm going to set my face against you, Negro. Why? Because you don't want to keep the commandments. Right. Why? Because you broke his covenant. Why? Because you don't want to do what God asked you to do. Read. Right.
And ye shall be slain before your enemy.
You want to know why our enemy's killing us? You want to know why the white man can come into this community and gun down a young black man? No problem. Because God said, read that again.
And ye shall be slain before your enemy.
God said, you're going to be slain before your enemies. Your enemy is going to kill you. Read.
They that hate you.
He said, the people that hate you. We know it ain't hard to tell that the white man hate our people.
Right.
Hell, he called you niggas. He enslaved you. Hell, he put you in the poorest parts of the cities. He won't give you no loans.
Right.
For real, though. He won't help build up your communities. He won't do a damn thing for you. And we shouldn't need him to help us do nothing, but we should come together and do it ourselves under the law, statutes, and commandments of the Most High.
Right.
Read that, saying they that who?
They that hate you.
God said the people that hate you, read,
shall reign over you.
He said the people that hate you gonna rule over you.
That's right.
Why all this happened? Because we broke God's covenant. We broke God's commandments.
Right.
So he said, the people that hate you, they're going to rule over you. So now you got to go to the people that hate you for a job. You sitting up here talking about, you wondering why you don't got a job. Because you got to go and sit in front of the people that hate you.
Right.
Hell, they hate your hair. So now what they want you to do, they want you to cut all your hair off your face. They want you to shave your face clean. They want you to cut your hair as low as you can possibly cut it. Because they hate your hair. They hate everything about you. For real, read that again.
They that hate you shall reign over you.
He said the people that hate you is the people that's going to rule over you. Them the people that's ruling over us, the people that hate us. That's why it's time for our people to wake up. Our people think everybody love us, though. Our people don't think we got no enemies. The white man ain't my enemy.
Right.
The Arabs ain't my enemy. You know who our enemy is? Your own brother is your enemy.
Right.
The person that looks just like you is your enemy. It's crazy as hell. Yeah, and that's what it is. And we be envious of one another. We if envious of one another and have hatred for one another, and we don't got nothing. It's crazy as hell how people break into the brother house next door to him. You'll break into the brother house next door to him, steal his stuff out. He don't got nothing the same way you don't got nothing. But you don't go into them rich communities where they got all the money in and break it and steal their stuff. You break into the, you destroy the people who don't got nothing. That's called crabs in a barrel. We destroy each other. It's time for our people to wake up, man. We are God's chosen people. Read on.
And ye shall flee when none pursue
you. He said you're going to flee when none pursue you. Read on.
And if you will not yet, for all these hearken unto me.
So God said, look, hey, read verse 16.
Verse
16.
16. I also will do this unto you. I will even appoint over you terror.
He said, I'm going to appoint terror over you. The Most High appointed terror over us. The white man is a goddamn terrorist.
That's right.
And the Lord had appointed that man over us. The white man is the true terrorist on this planet Earth.
That's right.
For real. Sit up there and talk about how evil black people is and how much crime black people do. But you don't see black people going to churches shooting churches up.
Right.
You don't see black people going to schools shooting schools up.
Right.
You don't see black people going in the club and killing everybody inside the club. And they might kill one brother outside the club. But they ain't sitting up there going out killing sprees, killing 50 and 60 folks. White people do that. They're the true terrorists on this planet Earth. The same way they came from the United States of America, they came from Spain, they came from Portugal, and they came to the west coast of Africa, and they terrorized you over there. Read that again.
I also will do this unto you. I will even appoint over you terror.
You hear that, bro? God said he's going to appoint a terrorist over us. The white man is a terrorist.
That's right.
For real, though. And we don't even see it no more. He's still terrorizing our people to this day. He said, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to stop food stamps. All right, this is going to terrorize them.
Right.
I'm going to pass certain laws that's going to affect their people. That's a damn terrorist right there. Which is going to cause chaos. I'm going to pass certain laws, standards and guidelines that's going to cause chaos amongst black people. That's called being a damn terrorist.
Right.
The white man been terrorizing black people since we got off them slave ships.
That's right.
But a lot of y'all like, no, man, God love everybody. You can't show me nowhere in the Bible where it say God love everybody. You just repeat what the Christian pastor, you repeat what the white man told the Christian pastor.
That's right.
The white man told the Christian pastor God love everybody. Oh, yeah, you know God love everybody. God coming to save everybody. God coming to save everybody. The white man told you that. The white man told you Jesus Christ coming to save everybody. That's another lie. That's how you know Christianity full of lies. Christianity full of lies. It's all about your money. Christianity allows you to be adulterer, allows you to be a whoremonger, allows you to be a drunkard, allows you to be a damn crackhead sitting on the corner in front of the damn pawn shop talking smack. That's what Christianity allows you to do. That's why the young men don't respect you older dudes in the community. That's why they don't respect you, man. For real, though. That's why these young niggas be smacking the hell out of y'all old dudes. For real, though. That's why these young niggas be smacking you, old dude.
That's right.
For real. Cause y'all some drunkards. They don't respect you.
Bring it out, Cap.
For real, though, you ain't men. Y'all are not men.
Right.
You don't know how to be a man. Give me that in 1 Kings. For real. You don't know how to show yourself a man. That's why you'll sit all the way over there talking smack, but won't come over here and say it in nobody's face. For real. Sit over there, smoke your crack, drink your beers, pop your pills. Stay in a dead state. Matter of fact, hold that. Give me Isaiah 58. 52.
Oh, wait.
You hear that? God said you need to wake up. Y'all old drunkards, you old fools. You need to wake up. Get off the white man's scrotum.
That's right.
White man pull up right now with a sack of crack. You'll do whatever for him.
Right.
And say yes, master, while you're doing it.
Right.
Read that again.
Oh, wait.
Time for our people to wake up, man. God asking you to wake up. Read.
Put on my strength.
He said put on your strength. Our strength is found in the Bible. Our strength is found in the commandments of God. Sister, pull on over, sis. Come hear the word of God. Come hear the word of God, sis. And find out where your strength at.
Yeah.
Find out what makes us perfect, what makes us strong, and how we can build a nation, how we can restore our nation.
Right.
Read that again.
Awake.
God said y'all need to wake up. Read on.
Put on thy strength.
Put on your strength. Your strength is in the Bible. Your strength is in the commandments of God. Read.
Oh, Zion, put on thy beautiful garments.
He said, put on your beautiful garments. Quit sagging your pants off your butt. Time for our people to wake up and repent, man.
That's right.
Hell, go right back to where you was at. When you men gonna show yourselves men? For real. Give me Genesis 18. I'm gonna show you how our forefathers was. Our forefathers didn't never sit on a cone all day, drink beer, smoke weed, and pop pills.
Right.
And mess with young men that's trying to do something positive in the community. You niggas make the community look bad.
Right.
These young men don't got nobody to look up to. They sure can't look up to you.
Right.
But that's what they see when they walk back and forth past her every day. They see the same drunk-ass niggas standing out here.
That's right.
Same drunk-ass niggas standing out here smoking crack. Right. Ain't doing nothing with their damn life.
Right.
Read what you got.
The book of Genesis, chapter 18 and verse 19.
Read what you got.
For I know him, that he will command his children.
You hear that? He said, I know Abraham. He said, I know Abraham. He said, Abraham gonna command his children, read.
That he will command his children.
Read.
And his household after him.
He said, I know Abraham. He gonna command his children and his household after him. Some of y'all kids don't even respect y'all. You never was in your damn kid life. Your kid don't even respect y'all.
Right.
Hell, a true man gonna command his children. A true man gonna command his household.
Yes.
A true man gonna build this something. Gonna build this community. Give me Genesis chapter 30, verse 30. A true man ain't gonna sit on a damn corner drinking beers, standing out here thinking they a young nigga. Won't can't establish nothing for our damn community. We can't come to you and ask for a job because your broke ass has destroyed your life. We can't ask you for no type of help. How can a young black man look up to you old niggas? Read.
The book of Genesis, chapter 30 and verse 30.
Read.
For it was little which thou hast before I came.
This is to our forefather Jacob. Read.
And it is now increased unto a multitude.
Read on.
And the Lord hath blessed thee since my coming. And now when shall I provide for mine own house
you
also?
You hear that? Listen to what he said. Listen to what Jacob said. Jacob said, when shall I provide for my house? When shall I provide for my house? A true man commands his household. A true man provides for his house.
Right.
Hell, you man. A true man don't sit on a corner all damn day. You supposed to grow up. You supposed to grow up out of that at some point.
Right.
Well, even if you still hustling out here, you supposed to come to the age. And when you sit up here and say, you know what, I've been hustling 20 years, I got it now. I got something established. You still selling nicks and dimes, you need to stop. You ain't no damn hustler.
Yeah.
You just smoke, sell a little something on the side and smoke a little something on the side. All right, I got this, I'm going to sell this little bit right here, and I'm going to smoke the rest.
That's right.
That ain't hustling.
Right.
Hell, that's a goddamn dope thing.
Right.
Hell wrong with y'all.
Bring it out.
For real, I ain't going to lie, man. I'm ready to execute judgment on them all today. I'm pissed.
Bring it out.
For real. I don't even, nobody better not come up here playing today. For real. They're going to see some real shit out here today. Read that again.
The book of Genesis, chapter 30 and verse 30.
Read.
For it was little which thou hast before I came.
He said, well, little one I had when I before I came. Because Jacob worked for Laban for 20 years. Jacob put in work. He put in 20 years. For real, Jacob supported his house. He supported his kids. He supported his wife. And he built the nation. Read.
And it is now increased unto a multitude.
Read.
And the Lord have blessed thee since my coming. And now when shall I provide for my own house?
A real man provides for his own house. That's what a real man do. Nobody don't want to whoop your ass. I'm going to whoop your ass with these scriptures.
That's right.
That's what I'm going to whoop your ass with. You can get your ass whooped with these scriptures out here.
Right.
See how wicked and evil you is. Damn sinner, drunkard, quit drinking. Quit getting drunk so damn much. For real though. Give me that real quick in 1 Corinthians chapter 6. For real. Lay off them damn beers. Maybe you can become something in life. For real. That's messed up. These young men can't look for the older men for nothing. Then you get mad when the young men get up on you. Then you want to talk mad. Come whoop my ass then. For real. I'm the young buck. Come whoop the young buck ass then.
That's right.
Need to grow a beard on your face. That's why these young kids don't respect you neither. Yeah. Try to look young like we look. You in your damn 50s.
Right.
You in your 60s. Yeah, you pushing everything, every bit of 60. Come over here.
Right.
Read.
The book of 1 Corinthians, chapter 6, and verse 9.
Know
ye not that the unrighteous.
Know ye not that the unrighteous. What it means to be unrighteous. Give me that in 1 John chapter 5. What it means to be unrighteous.
Get out.
The book of 1 John, chapter 5, and verse 17.
Read it.
All unrighteousness
is sin. It say all unrighteousness is sin. All unrighteousness is sin.
Right.
It said the unrighteous, go right back to where you was at. I want to show you what unrighteousness was is according to the Bible. Y'all know it's a new breed of black men on earth. We're going to take these streets back.
Yes,
sir. Guarantee you. We're going to take these streets back and we're going to clean these streets up one day. For real, the day and the hour coming where people ain't going to be able to get drunk on the street.
That's right.
These women ain't going to be able to walk around naked showing off their body. It ain't going to be no prostitution. It ain't going to be no crack being sold, no weed being sold. The day and the hour coming.
Right.
For real, though. I got respect for them black men that stood up for something in the 60s. At least the households was together then.
Right.
Y'all let the white man bring crack in your communities and destroy you. Then you niggas created gangs. Then you grab guns and start killing each other for some damn paper. For real, though. And now, as you grew older, you can't even see the damn damage that the white man had done to you.
Right.
You know, you can't even put nothing in place to help the youth that's coming up amongst you. That's why the youth do not respect you.
Right.
The youth don't respect you. That's why our women don't respect us.
Right.
Why you think they go pray to the white man as God? Cause you niggas won't even, you niggas can't even repent and become gods in your
own. See the treatment of God. We are not black men, we are the Israelites.
Nathaniel of Israel United in Christ. Please subscribe to our YouTube channels. Stay up to date with our latest events, music, and classroom lessons. IUIC plans to continue visiting different countries where this gospel has not been preached before. IUIC needs your help in pushing this truth. So join us. Subscribe to our Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and podcast, and stay up to date with us. For more information, please visit www.israelunite.org.